Why did you break off your engagement? Why did you never come over and visit us after that? Why won't you come and see us tonight? No! You don't need to say anything. I see it all now. So that was why you... And why you? And why you? Yes, of course. Now it all adds up. So that was it. Ugh. I don't want to sit at the same table as you. That's why I had to embroider tulips, which I hate, on his slippers. Because you liked tulips. That is why we had to spend our holiday in Malren that summer, because you can't stand the sea. That is why my son had to be called Eskel. Because that was your father's name. Oh, that's why I had to wear your colors. Read your authors. Eat your dishes. Drink your drinks. Your chocolate, for instance. That was why. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, it's horrible. Horrible now that I think of it. Everything. Everything that belonged to you entered into me. Even your passions. Your soul crept into mine, like a worm into an apple, eating and eating, boring and boring till there was nothing left but skin and a little black mold. I wanted to run away from you. But you lay there like a snake, bewitching me with your black eyes. When I tried to use my wings, they dragged me down. I lay in the water with my feet bound, and the more I tried to swim with my hands, the deeper I sank. Down, down, till I reached the bottom, where you lay like a giant crab ready to seize me in your claws. And I'm lying there now. Oh, I hate you. Hate you, hate you! But you just sit there. Silent, calm, not caring. Not caring whether it's night or day, summer or winter, whether other people are happy or miserable. Unable to hate and unable to love. Motionless like a stork over a rat hole. You couldn't pounce on your victim. You couldn't hunt it, but you could wait for it. You sit here in your corner. Do you know people call this the rat trap because of you? And read your papers to see if anyone's in trouble or ill or has gotten the sack from the theater. You sit here reckoning your victims, calculating your opportunities like a pilot counting his shipwrecks, like a goddess receiving sacrifice. Poor Amelia. Do you know that I feel sorry for you? Because I know you're unhappy. Unhappy like someone who's been hurt. And evil because you've been hurt. I can't be mad at you. Though I'd like to be. Because you're the one who is the baby, not me. Oh, and that business with Bob doesn't bother me. Why should it? And why does it matter whether you taught me to drink chocolate or someone else did? It's all one in the end. Anyway. Chocolate's very healthy. And if you've taught me how to dress,
tant mieux.
It's only made my husband fonder of me. Your loss has been my gain. And to judge by certain signs, I'd say you've lost him. I suppose you'd hoped I'd run away. But you're the one who's run away. And now you're sitting here regretting it ever happened. But I don't regret it. One mustn't be petty. And besides, why should I want to own something which no one else wants? You know what? Maybe when all is said and done, I really am the stronger of us two. Now, anyway, you never took anything from me. You only gave. And now I'm like the thief in the fairy tale. You woke and I'd gone off with all your treasure. Otherwise, why did everything become worthless and sterile as soon as you touched it? You couldn't keep any man's love for all your tulips and your passions, as I have done. Your authors never taught you how to live, but they taught me. You never had any little Eskel. You only had a father called Eskel. And why are you always so silent, silent, silent? I used to think it was because you were strong. But now I think it's just that you had nothing to say. Because your head was empty. And now I'm going home. And I'm taking the tulips with me. Your tulips. You could never learn anything from other people. You could only give. And so you broke, like a dry reed. But I didn't. Thank you, Amelia, for all the good lessons. Thank you for teaching my husband to love. And now I'm going home to love him.